Hi everyone, welcome to this review note. In this clip, we are going to be looking at saving and restoring configurations in iOS and also reloading the device. Starting off, I'm in user mode. I'm going to go and make a configuration change first, not save it, and see what happens from there. So I'm going to do enable to get into the privilege mode. I'm going to change into global config. And from here, I'm just going to change the host name so there is something different. We can see that our prompt changed because I changed the host name. That's now the beginning of the prompt. I'm going to exit out of here, go back to privileged mode, and once I'm here, I'm going to reboot the machine, which we might do either by command or might be a power failure. Can use the reload command, which is going to be the same result whether there actually was a power failure or actually whether we manually rebooted the device. So it comes back up, we'll take a look and see what happens to our device configuration. You can see by the prompt that we're now back to the host name of being switched, the generic, which means that we made some changes that were not saved out. What if we want to save those changes? Let me go back in quickly to config T and I'll change the host name back again. Right, so our host name is now SW1. If I want to keep that, what I need to do is copy the running config, that's which resident in memory, to startup config, which is in non-volatile memory. Copy. For the command running config, we're going to hit R and tab. We can tab out to fill all that in. And then startup config is going to be the destination. So I'm going to copy the running config, memory resident, and the startup config, which will go to non-volatile memory. Hit enter. It's going to prompt for the destination file name. Is it startup config you want to copy to? One thing to remember, we don't put in Y or yes or anything like that, because if we do that, it's going to change the file name from startup config to Y or yes, whatever you type. We just hit enter to confirm, and that's now done. Now, if I reload, what will happen is the system will come back with the saved configuration. Try that out. We'll give it a second to reload, and once it's done, we should see that our command prompt is going to begin with SW1, which is the host name of the device. So get started, we can see that is the case. Now, what happens if we make some changes and we accidentally made these changes, we don't like them, and we'd like to restore to where we were? It's also very easy. Let me make a change, I'll just change the host name so it's obvious what we're doing. So I enter the incorrect host name. Whatever it is I configured, I don't like it. What I can do very easily is now copy startup config, what's in non-volatile memory, to running config, which will load into RAM what is in that non-volatile file. I'll confirm, yes, that's what I want to do. And notice now that my configuration goes back to what it was before I made those changes. Last thing to look at, what if I want to wipe the configuration completely? One of the things, of course, that will happen when we reboot is it's going to load the startup config to be our current configuration. Need to get rid of that. I can say erase startup config and then confirm that I want to do that. So startup config is now no longer there. If I reboot, what should end up happening is I'm back to factory default, meaning that the host name on our switch is going to be simply switch instead of SW1, which we set it to previously. So now boot it back up again, and there we go. That's basically saving, restoring, wiping out permanent configurations. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.